to invite, to welcome you guys to the fifth annual peritoneal service PMP program, peritoneal service malignancy program here at UMass, directed by my colleague, Dr. Laura Lambert, who we all love and support. I want to do a little bit of housekeeping work for you first. You need to know that the bathrooms are located out the door and down the hall to the right, conveniently next to the vendor tables that are here. I want to thank particularly the peritoneal, the PMP Research Foundation, which has supported this this endeavor since Dr. Lambert has arrived, and I know that Carroll in the back there is standing there to make sure that we do everything right. I want to particularly thank our visitors. Dr. Jesus Escobar has already given us a great talk this morning in the Department of Surgery for our for surgical grand rounds on this topic, and I know that he's going to talk about it wonderfully. We have Dr. Switzer, I see in the back, ready to talk about the medical advances that we're making. And of course, Dr. Briner, who I know you all met last year, who is helping us find a better way to treat this even than what Dr. Escobar will suggest. And so with that, I think I should turn it over to the next individual. Laura, you're going to moderate this, aren't you? So as we all know, that Laura has set this up to tell you all what we're doing here at UMass. I can vouch for the fact that we support this enormously. We're very proud of the multidisciplinary effort and team that we put together to take care of this very difficult problem directed by Dr. Lambert. She's been simply wonderful, and her focus, as always, has been on all of you, the patients who have, patients and their families who have suffered through this disease and this process. Laura, congratulations on a wonderful program for your fifth effort here.
Thank you, Giles, and good morning and welcome, everybody. As Giles mentioned, this is our fifth annual PMP Appendiceal Cancer Symposium, and we're just delighted that all of you can make it. Again, like as he said, really the intent of this day is for all of you. It's for people who have this disease and the families who are supporting them, the friends who are here to support them. It's an opportunity for you to look around the room and see that despite the fact that this is a rare cancer, you're not alone. That there are other people who are dealing with this, who are interested in treating it, to find a better way to treat it, and to help you do as well as you can for as long as you can, and to cure this and to conquer this disease. So I certainly hope that you just recognize that's what this event is really about. It's about you. We're just here to support you, answer questions, and hopefully get everybody working together to find a better treatment and a cure for this. And on that note, I'm going to turn the time over to Mr. Jim Carroll, who is here to represent the PMP Research Foundation, and this is their mission. And so, Jim.
Thank you, Laura. Good morning. The PMP Research Foundation is proud for the fifth year to collaborate with UMass Memorial Medical Center through sponsorship of today's symposium. Let me begin by thanking Laura, thanking Dora Haddock and the planning committee, Dr. Whalen, Dr. Escobar, and the other speakers. I'm very excited to take a few minutes in the beginning of it to just share a little bit about our foundation's story. For most of our board members and our many supporters within the patient community, our stories are very similar. The story begins with the diagnosis of PMP or appendix cancer, and oftentimes, too often, a misdiagnosis of PMP, followed by a struggle to understand the disease and seek out potential treatment options. Often this occurs in an environment where sometimes the doctor is being consulted for treatment and diagnosis has never seen PMP and have limited or no knowledge of the disease. For patients, it can be a roller coaster of emotions with decisions being made, having life or death consequences, as many of you know. For my good friend Judy Culbertson and I, that journey began in 2004 when my buddy Dutch was diagnosed. He subsequently lost his battle in 2006 to PMP. Following his passing, Judy set out to make a difference, and she initiated for the first time a cancer walk in Philadelphia to raise funds. Only after the walk did we look around and had trouble figuring out who do we donate the funds to, because there was no central organization working on PMP research. We were very fortunate following that to find that the PMP Research Foundation was being formed at that stage. And the foundation was created by a wonderful woman, Lisa Luciano, very courageous, mother of eight children, who recognized the need to support the specialists by trying to create and obtain some funding for research. Lisa created the foundation along with her co-founders at the time, Jerry Lewandowski, who's our president, Mike Dvorsky, Dan Luciano, and Kathy Hoover. Susan Ortega, Judy, John Zisk, and I joined shortly after that. The PMP Research Foundation was formed as an all-volunteer organization, and our mission is from the heart. We have no paid individuals. Board members volunteer their time after their full-time careers for this cause, sometimes between treatments and hospital stays. Our mission was simple. We were dedicated to funding research to find a cure for PMP and appendix cancer. Our initial goal that we set was to try to raise $1 million within 5 years for important research and education, and thankfully we were able to do that. We hit that mark in 2013 and now have surpassed it. We have a professional advisory board of which Laura is a member, and their guidance and support is critical to how we run our organization and the success of the organization. In addition to hitting the $1 million mark, we are positioned through our website and our fundraising efforts to basically build additional fundraising for anyone that wants to volunteer and have an event. The website enables us to do that. So our infrastructure is set up that if we continue to have participation from the patient community and support of the specialists, we will be able to grow the organization. So I wanted to speak for a couple minutes and show you some of the events that we have. This is the Dutch event in Philadelphia that Judy and I created. We have, that's one of the type of events we have. The Summer Scurry is a similar event, the 5K out in Ohio that the Luciana family started. Everybody likes the pub crawl. This looks like a pub crawl crowd. Okay. We have two pub crawls that we've done. One is relatively locally in Connecticut, and the other is in Chicago in memory of Keith and in memory of Doug Selman. Derek Corner's family runs a rock and roll show in near Boston each year, and we just for the first time had a very great event called Hoops for the Cure down in North Carolina. It's a full-blown basketball challenge. So you can see that there's a number of different things that people do. We actually have a shooting event at a gun show that somebody's creating, and we're planning on kicking off March Madness this year as well. So if you see it on the site, please feel free to jump in. As far as the education piece, we're committed to education for both the patient and medical community. As you know, this is the fifth symposium at UMass. This year we were also, in the last couple months, able to get a West Coast symposium hosted by Dr. Lowy, and we did a Midwest symposium in Chicago hosted by Dr. Salty. We're starting to try to fund scholarships for medical students also to attend these events to get more doctors into the seats. Next year, right now, in the pipeline, we've got Drexel University College of Medicine in Philadelphia scheduled for April, hosted by Dr. Wilbur Bowen. and we're hoping to play a role in the 10th International Congress of PSM next November. So far, our grant program, we've been able to issue $750,000 in 16 grants, and there's a sheet back at the table that shows all of the different really international grants that were issued and all of the people that are working on trying to find the answers. It's administered by the National Organization for Rare Diseases, and currently they're the ones that do the evaluation and the scoring. What are the results of it? So far we've had 10 published works and peer-reviewed journals coming out of it. First prize at the 2012 PSM Congress and human clinical trials at UPMC. So that gives you a little bit of an idea of what our organization's all about. In closing, I'd like to say to our specialists, to Laura Lambert, and all of today's presenters, we thank you for your leadership and your support, and ask for your ongoing support and participation with our organization. To the doctors, nurses, and students in the audience today, we're appreciative of your attendance, and we firmly believe that you'll be able to apply the education you receive today and affect the outcome of patients in the future in a very positive way. To the PMP PALS organization, volunteers, Pat Olson and Mary Grimm, thank you very much for outstanding work that your organization is doing to support the patient community. And to the patients in the audience, as Laura said, it's about you. We want you to know that you're not alone. Know that we're here to support you and invite you and your family members to join us and support us. Know that progress is being made and worked on and passionately chased after, and there continues to be survivor success stories every day, as you will hear today. Stay strong, never give up. Thank you.